Welcome to the EPSS. EPSS stands for Electronic Power System Simulation. Nowadays, applications in the power electronic domain are relying more and more on physical modeling, and this is putting a lot of effort for the real-time simulation. Just to mention a few, the high switching frequency of all the active components, the high dynamic of the model compared to the standard mechanical system, for example, and the changing of the structure of the model we are simulating because of the semiconductor devices which are activating and during the simulation. So here at dSPACE, we have developed this EPSS solution to help all our customers to tackle these problems. So our system is extremely flexible and expandable. You can see here a Scalexio lab box with a processor 6001, which is a quad core, together with few FPGAs also in the box. And the FPGAs can be connected through optical link over a very low latency protocol, and the different box can be connected also with each other. In this way, you can have a very sophisticated architecture with multiple FPGA and multiprocessor architecture. From the software point of view, the library consists of two different parts. One is the FPGA part, and the other one is the processor part, depending where you want to run the model to. From the user point of view, they are very easy to use. You can just simply export a file, which then can be imported automatically in a configuration desk, and from there you can build your application. The EPSS library is fully integrated into the dSPACE toolchain. With the EPSS library, for example, you can have an FPGA running the model developed with the EPSS, and another FPGA developed with the XSG library. And then you can put the two FPGAs in communication with each other and build a multi-FPGAs platform, for example. What I want to show you now is an example of a model developed with the Synscape library. And I want to show you how easy it is to go from offline simulation in Simulink to the real-time simulation on the FPGA. So in this model here, we have a rectifier, a three-phase rectifier, followed by a DC link, and then followed again by a buck converter, where you have the diode here, the switch, and then the two capacitor and the load here. So if we want to run this model on FPGA, all we need to do is go into the setup block. This block is part of the EPSS library. And with this block, you can configure not only the FPGA you want to run the model onto, but you can also configure the sample time, the time step of the model. Or if you select minimum here, then the system will work out itself, which is the minimum sample time that the model can run on the FPGA. You can also set the algorithm, the solver algorithm here with this selection. And then when you have done all this configuration, all you need to do is click on this button. And this button is generating the EPSS file. This file is a description of the topology of your circuit. And with this file, you can import this file into configuration desk, and from there you can build the application for the FPGA. So as soon as you have generated the EPSS file from the model, you can come here in configuration desk and then select the function EPSS on FPGA. You drag and drop your function into the function column here, and then as soon as you do that, you'll be prompt to select the EPSS file. So you can select your file that has been just generated, and then from there you can select which signals are coming from which part. For example, the switch can come from the processor or can come from a digital input line. You can do all this kind of configuration. When you have done this, the function will be configured exactly for your specific model. So, and then all you need to do is in the hardware assignment, you need to specify your FPGA. In my case, I have to select the 6601, the baseboard. And then after you have done this, you can just drag and drop the model into this function port, and this will automatically create the model port blocks, which are essential for the configuration of your application. At this point, you just click on the start button, and configuration desk will do the job for you. We'll build, we generate the code, we'll build application, and we'll download the application to the real-time Scalexio and FPGA as well. And from there on, using Control Desk, for example, you can monitor the application in real-time from your PC. This was a quick introduction on the EPSS library and what it's capable of. If you are interested in learning more, please get in touch with us.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.